Weight loss versus fat loss. Welcome to Best Dieting Tips channel. In this video, we will learn the difference between weight loss and fat loss. Before starting this video, please subscribe to our channel, like and share this video. Weight loss and fat loss are two different things. Weight loss is an overall decrease in body weight. This includes muscle, fat and water from the body. Weight loss is simply a loss of overall body weight. Whereas fat loss is a reduction in body fat. Reducing body fat is what most people want to achieve. Fat loss is more specific than weight loss. Focus on fat loss, not weight loss. Many weight loss programs claim to help you lose weight quickly and easily. However, it's important to realize that a significant amount of this weight may include water and muscle losses. Losing muscle can be harmful, as muscle is a crucial component of your overall health. Maintaining a healthy percentage of muscle has several benefits, such as regulating healthy blood sugar levels, maintaining healthy fat levels, like triglycerides and cholesterol, in the blood, and controlling inflammation. Indeed, several studies have linked a higher fat-to-muscle ratio to chronic diseases like metabolic syndrome, heart disease, and diabetes. Maintaining your muscle mass may also reduce your risk of age-related muscle loss, which results in weakness and potentially disability. Additionally, the more muscle you have, the more calories you burn at rest. This is the main reason why men generally have higher calorie needs than women. As a result, losing weight in the form of muscle can decrease the number of calories you burn at rest, making it easier to regain any weight you lost in the form of fat. There are a few simple ways to ensure you'll lose weight in the form of fat and either maintain or gain muscle mass. These include eating plenty of protein, exercising regularly, and following a nutrient-dense diet that puts you in a slight calorie deficit. How to build muscle or maintain muscle and lose fat only. Eat plenty of protein. Protein is an important nutrient for a variety of bodily functions. It's necessary to make enzymes that help with digestion and energy production, regulate fluid balance, and support immune health, among other functions. Protein is also important for maintaining the muscle you have and supporting new muscle growth, especially when losing weight. In one study found that high-intensity resistance exercise followed by a high-protein recovery snack made the most difference. Also, it limited the men's fat intake to create a calorie deficit and maintained their carb intake for adequate exercise fuel. And while eating plenty of protein with a reduced calorie diet without weight training may not help you gain muscle, it may help you maintain muscle while increasing fat loss. Protein requirement may differ, person to person, depending on your age, health, sex, and physical activity level. Consuming protein in the range of 1 gram to 1.6 grams per kilogram of your body weight per day can support muscle mass retention and fat loss with dieting. Exercise is the most effective way to encourage fat loss rather than muscle loss. A review of 6 studies found that older adults with obesity who engaged in cardio and weight training at least 3 times per week while following a calorie-restricted diet retained 93% more of their muscle than those who did not exercise. Certainly, exercise alone is an effective strategy to maintain muscle mass with dieting, but combining exercise with a higher protein intake may help optimize your results. The physical activity guidelines for Americans recommend adults get at least 150 to 300 minutes per week of cardio and muscle strengthening activities that involve all major muscle groups. Follow a reduced calorie diet to lose weight. You must cut the calorie from your diet. You can create a calorie deficit by eating fewer calories or exercising, but preferably both. However, cutting your calories too much can lead to a greater loss of muscle rather than fat. Instead, aim to moderately reduce the number of calories you consume by 500 to 600 per day to minimize muscle loss while still facilitating fat loss. You can reduce the number of calories by eating more fruits, vegetables, whole grains, lean protein foods, low-fat dairy, and fewer sugar-sweetened products and beverages, processed meats, and fried foods. Conclusion: weight loss refers to a decrease in your overall body weight, whereas fat loss refers to weight loss that occurs specifically from losses in fat mass. A body fat scale or skinfold caliper is more useful for monitoring fat loss than tracking your body weight alone. Other simple ways to access fat loss include measuring inches or centimeters lost from your waist and hips and noting any changes in how your clothes fit around your waist. Losing weight in the form of fat rather than muscle should be the priority given how important your fat-to-muscle ratio is to your overall health. You can prioritize fat loss by eating plenty of protein, exercising, and moderately restricting your calories. Thank you for watching.